Hello, ladies and gentlemen.
This is Papa Bale, and welcome to the channel. I was just doing some art here with the pulse motor. And I'll remove it now, let it dry. Look at that. It's pretty neat. I'm doing like three colors right now, but I might increase that eventually. Okay, so today we are going to explore how these iron cores are affect. It's really hard for me to tell you that, how it affects it. I don't know myself exactly what goes on. There's like some kind of imprint, magnetic imprint, I guess, that is completed when the core is full and the center is filled. But I was thinking about adding these ferrite magnets, I got six of them, in different places to help it move along faster. But I believe that the torque is greatly increased because it's still moving really, really fast. But there's a pole there, a magnetic pole, because it's soft iron. So there's definitely something slowing it down as well, really. Kinda. Doesn't seem to be going that slow though. But because there is a core in there that is magnetic, this will slow down really, really fast. Let me grab the magnets. All right. I don't know if that's right. We're just going to put it there because it's stable. Yeah, that feels wrong. I gotta make sure they're facing the right way. Come on, stop doing that. That's really bugging me now. Stop. Alright, so I think, even if we move it out, which about right here. Now I gotta get the glue. Make sure all that glue gets into the trash too. I've gone through like a whole bag of glue in the last night. God, man, this is... really annoying. So I think that might work. That angle, because it... push it right along. I hope that's going the right way. Yeah, we gotta run it real quick to see if I'm going the right way. I think I'm not going the right way. Yeah, we gotta change it. Gonna change the orientation to go that way. So that sucked. Just right there. It's like almost perfect. Doing that all the time. All right, so we got one set up. I'm not sure if I'm going to keep it there. Just to show you kind of what goes into calibrating all this stuff so that it runs nice and smooth. I'm gonna have to readjust my maybe he was talking about a heater for the glue, but still, there's all this cardboard stuff in it. It's useless. Now, see, I think the iron coils is what's making it go so slow. Well, let's see how quickly it picks up speed here. Let me turn on the power. It's going to be interesting to see. Wow, man, it's like already up to speed. Awesome, look at that, that is going really good. I don't know if the magnets are helping at this point. I know the torque is going to be phenomenal on this. Wow, that is powerful. That's shaking me. Shaking this whole thing. This table weighs like 65 pounds at least. Well, I don't know. It could weigh more than that. It's treated lumber down here on the bottom. So yeah, I don't know really how to assess it right now. I kind of want to take the cores out and see how well. Let's do that. Yep, here it comes. Alright. We can always put it back in. Yeah, I think this is gonna work phenomenally well without the iron cores in there. Maybe when we do some generation stuff, like generator-ish stuff-ish, we'll use the cores again. We'll see. How much more energy we generate with one with a core, or three with a core, or a circuit with a cores. Yeah, look at that. That's really good. Let's start it up. Wow. Really? Wow. The accelerate at this point, I don't know what the deal is. Maybe the bearing is getting weak. I don't know what happens right there. I took the cores out and like all the speed went away. Gnarly. You saw how with the cores in there and it had the table like shaking, right? Wow, that is impressive. I think I'm gonna have to put the cores back in. I really do. Because this took forever. Just to get to here, and we're not really at the shaking phase yet. Wow. Yeah, so that's a huge difference if you can remember seeing with the cores in how fast that went, how quickly it got there. I don't know what's going on with this. This is different. Maybe we're clipping some enamel, I don't know. But we're just getting to the table shaking phase. Let's see. I'm gonna put, I don't know if this is smart putting this in here while it's moving, but we're gonna give it a shot. Wow. That's one. let's just turn the power off and let it simmer down. Yeah, that's a huge difference, man. Wow, big difference.
Of course that's what she said. But we're not going to go there, because that's not what this channel is about. Unbelievable difference.
Alright, we are coming up on the end of our video. Alright, now watch how fast that goes. Now how fast it gets there. Look at that. It's mang. It's not even funny how much faster this got to where it needed to go. Table is already shaking like violently. All right, we're gonna cut it. That's awesome. I don't know how much RPMs that is, but I think it's pretty high. I mean, not drastically high, but it's high enough to generate some electricity. Capacitors, man. Gotta do the capacitation. Capacitance. Gotta get going. Look at all this. Look at all that. All this and that, some of this, a little bit of that. Now I can see just by looking here that this coil is in the wrong spot. I need to move that. And then it'll be pretty good, pretty badass.
So the pulse motor, permanent magnet, acceleration, phase, monitor, meter, tech, boost, rudimentary style pulse motor. Look at that, it really wants to move. It really, really, really wants to move. So it just needs that little nudge. Boom. And if you can get a full rotation off of one hump, then that means you just did, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then the one that you did, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. It's a lot, man. It's like almost 3 full rotations minus the one that you started with. See, now I have a motor, I have two motors. Which will allow me to connect two of these magnets, one on either side of a pole or a shaft in the motor, and then that'll have it'll either allow it to spin when it's spinning or it'll spin. You know, a little bit of power, or and then I have pulleys. I have a turbine generator. It's not a wind turbine necessarily, but you spin the shaft and it generates electricity. It's got a north pole and a bottom pole shaft, so it's got a top coming out the top and coming out the bottom. So I guess you could hook up a wind if you wanted to. But we're gonna spin one of these apparatuses. See here? This lathe motor, permanent magnet motor. We're gonna run that with the magnet on there. So something to do. So we're gonna see if the pulse motor will spin, or we turn the power off, we turn the pulse motor on, and we see if the magnet will spin. If the magnet spins, then we hook the turbine generator up to this shaft. And I'll show you what they look like in just a moment. This here is a 3-foot iron pole. See, it is iron. It's very attracted to metallic and magnetic thingamajobs. All right, so basically, put it like down in here somewhere, like right in here. We got the motor underneath, and it'll spin pretty easily because it's nice and loose in the hole right there. It'll spin. If we get the magnets on there well enough, they'll spin too. And we can either spin the magnets right here, or this can spin the magnets for us. I'm hoping that'll work. You just gotta get the magnets like way down here on the pole.
All right, yeah.
Woo, that's pretty cool. All right, have a good night. Peace out. Please subscribe and have a good night.